Every human being that you know always is going to gravitate towards the finesse of things, things that wow them, things that capture their imagination, things that just take their breath away, things of excellence, things of magnificence, things of grandeur, things of glory. And that's what we're discussing in these episodes as we are talking and considering some mistakes that we make with our personal brands. And today we're going to add one more mistake that people normally make with their personal brands. And excuse the bird in the background. One of the mistakes that people are always making with their personal brand is something so simple and something that can be fixed so easily. But it is very extremely common on a daily basis. So stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
One of the worst words or a phrase you can ever hear from a human being is, "I don't care." And one of the most appealing, most perfect phrase you can hear from a human being is, "I care." That is a revolutionary statement. To care is a powerful thing. To care even when you do not have the wherewithal to, as long as the heart and the thought is there. Normally people say it is the thought that counts. I have a problem with that because I normally think that if you can think and you can put it into action, because the thought is not seen, the action is what is seen. It is the action that matters, the action of care. The action of care is the one that makes a difference, not the thought. But just to know that someone cares, to feel that someone cares, is a revolutionary proposition. And we've been discussing in these episodes about personal branding, and we've been saying that the world is so noisy these days that if you're going to transact, if you're going to be engaged, if you're going to add value into this world, you're going to add value to the degree that you do have a personal brand or not. If you do not have a personal brand, it becomes easy for you to get lost in the crowds, because the crowds are actually very many. And the answer to that, the answer of standing out, is to package yourself as a brand. And so we've been discussing some of the mistakes that people normally make, and they become lousy with their brands. And the first thing we said is that everyone does have a brand. Whether you know it or you don't, you do have a brand. People perceive you. Perception is what constitutes a brand. I perceive you by the things that I see you are passionate about, by the value that I see you're offering, by the things that I see you fronting. I perceive you that way. And now I can be able to engage you in that particular manner, or I can be able to tell someone else about you to the degree that I know you're an expert or you're passionate about that area. And so the very first mistake people normally make is to think that they are not a brand. Ignorance of their brand. When you are ignorant about your brand, you are shooting yourself in the foot in the very first place. Because the opposite is true. When you are aware that you are a brand, you're going to be circumspect about it. You're going to treat yourself about it That way, you're going to show the world about your passion, and the world eventually will start communicating and engaging with you commensurate to the clarity of your personal brand. The second mistake normally people make, and we discussed that yesterday, is that people are not clear about their brands. People do not want to miss out on prospective clients, and so they are offering just about everything. They are saying, I can do this, I can do that. People have not learned to say no to requests that do not meet their niche, requests that are not in their line of trade, the requests that are not in their area of passion, area of expertise, because they think that that's the money that I'm going to lose. And so they end up taking very many things that are not necessarily connected to their passion and not connected to their brand, and then they are not known for it. First of all, they start wasting time doing that which is not something that is adding value to their brand, something that the time that they would have used to up and sharpen their brand, that time would have been used better that way. And now they are taking very many things and they're spreading themselves very thin, and their brand is as clear as mud. Who are you? What do you do? People do not know. Oh, he can repair a shoe, he can repair a bicycle, he can be a very powerful speaker. I mean, he writes very nice articles, he's a very good podcaster. But what does he do? What does he do? What exactly is he about? What is his value add? People are going to interact with you and engage you as long as you are sharp and you're focused. See, the notion that if you say no to requests that do not fit in your personal brand, you will lose money and you will lose a market share is false. The opposite is actually true. The more sharper you are, the more you are standing out from the noise. But if you spread yourself too thin and you can do very many things, you're becoming noisy, and people do not want noise. People want harmony. People want tune, something that has been fine-tuned, and that takes clarity to do it. Today, we're going to discuss something simple about a mistake that people normally make with their personal brand. And number three is this: lousiness, not paying attention to detail, being cheap with your brand, selling your brand on the cheap, just being functional and not being excellent, not minding finesse, not minding details. This is a lackadaisical attention to excellence of your brand. It is a simple thing that kills you. See, these things are the ones that contribute to us becoming lousy and just being a semblance of what we could be, and not being exactly that. Seeing always having a promise, always having a potential to do it, but we're never rising up to becoming it. Why? Because we are lousy. We already know that we have a brand, but we are not paying attention to detail. We're not giving 100% connection, 100% effort, 100% passion, 100% effort to it, 100% energy to it. And so we are lousy. I mean, we are okay just slapping a name on it. I see people doing lousy things. I mean, you're writing a book, for example. Let me just use that as an example of a book. And I see those books even in bookshelves. Someone has written a book, and guess what? They're gone to Microsoft Word and they have created a cover page for the book. And they are not even graphic designers in the first place. It becomes so lousy. And you look at the content. The content can be impeccable, yes, but the cover is absolutely lousy. Something is an eyesore, something you do not want to be associated with. That's lousiness. Why? Because they are working on the cheap. They do not want to consider employing someone who can expend their expertise and their excellence, because that's what their brand is. Their brand is to create aesthetics and create for you a nice cover page. And so you end up being lousy because you wanted to save money. See, brands are going to cost you an arm and a leg. Excellence is going to cost you a lot. But these small, tiny things are the ones that normally take away from our cutting edge of our personal brands. See, Muhammad Ali says that it's not the mountains ahead to climb that wears you down. It is the pebble in your shoe. And when it comes to personal branding, it is the small little details that do matter. Small things that you know, are glaring in attention. When someone sees that you've paid attention to detail and you are magnificent, you are excellent, you are glorious in what you're doing, then it becomes easy for you to stand out from the noise, because everyone else is making noise with their lousy brands. Everyone else is pasting saying, I am an author. Everyone else is saying that I am a writer. Everyone else is saying that I am a podcaster. Everyone else is saying that I am a public speaker. I'm a motivational speaker, you know, having a few lines of this person and the other person crammed from Google and going around reciting that they are speakers. That's lousy. And anyone can do that. For you and I, we need to go an extra mile. It is the little things about our brand that kill it. The fonts, the spelling, the grammar, the color, too much information, and so on. This means that we have to have a killer brand again. Great attention must be put on every little detail to it. It takes time. It takes time to make this brand fine. The third biggest mistake people make is carelessness and laziness in building the brand. I mean, you've got to pay an arm and a leg for your brand to come strong, for your brand to come to the fore. You've got to basically differentiate yourself. Like we said yesterday in the podcast, that distinction. Authenticity is an important thing. Simplicity is an important thing. Distinction is also a very important thing. And distinction comes when you decide to infuse your brand with excellence, to infuse your brand with finesse, to infuse your brand with glory, to pay attention to it, to sway, to pay an arm and a leg for it, to pay for time, to pay for your heart, to pay for your passion, basically to hard work. People normally hide in this adage of work smart and don't work hard. There is nothing like that. Working smart does not negate the fact that you cannot work hard. Working smart means that you're working in your area of expertise, but working hard also on it. And that's what is going to count for a great brand. Don't be lousy. Don't stoop low just to be counted as I'm just among us those guys who are doing this. But let there be some kind of finesse in it. Look for very many areas of finesse you can be able to put in your personal brand. It could be the process. It could be the creation. It could be the interface that you're having with your people. It could be a wow that you are always creating, always innovating. Don't make your brand to be ordinary. There is a book called The Mistake Called Average. I think that's the title of the book, something about average. Don't be average. Be exceptional. Choose to be exceptional. And the problem, like I said yesterday, people normally look at these things that we pay to be exceptional, and they're looking at what is the feedback coming out of it. I'm not getting paid at the end of the month. I'm not getting paid at the end of the year. So let me not add this finesse business into it. Listen, at the end of the day, it is going to pay off. And when it starts paying off, you can never go wrong with excellence. We're going to discuss something else tomorrow that contributes to a lousy brand. Until then, bye-bye. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.